What is up, SmackNPie? SmackNPie here, and welcome back to another news update video. Today's gonna be a little bit different because we're not just talking about Dark Deception. If you just want to listen to Dark Deception news, you can skip ahead, but I would recommend you to stay a bit and watch all of the video because I'm going to show you some of the good stuff. Little Nightmares, Resident Evil 3, all of that good stuff coming up in this video. So without wasting any more time, let us begin. Firstly, we're gonna start off with Resident Evil 3, one of the most awaited remakes of any horror game in a while, after Resident Evil 2, of course. Resident Evil 3, Nemesis Remake. I uploaded a video showing off demo gameplay, and it was looking fantastic. I would highly recommend you guys to check out that video first, but you can get your full hands on that demo late this month. It is supposed to come out for everyone to play for free. Well, hopefully the Resident Evil 3 demo will release later this month with possible no more delays for full game to drop this year. We will be keeping an eye out on that. You need to play this game. If not, at least watch the last video. You will change your mind about this game. And then we have Little Nightmares 2, one of the most awaited indie horror games that you guys are looking forward to on the channel that you want me to cover. Little Nightmares 2 is supposed to come out mid-2020, and we have seen a couple of trailers and a couple of teasers. I've been covering this game very closely, and I've been keeping an eye out on this game as well. We covered Hunter and so many other monsters, but Little Nightmares 2 official Twitter account posted another new enemy teaser. Let's take a look. They said on Twitter, "Her methods are unconventional, but you cannot argue with the results," showing off the teacher teaser. In the trailer, in the first trailer that we've seen, the reveal trailer, we saw a classroom with students with that haircut, but we also saw this lady, and it's very interesting because here in this picture, she's looking way too tall for that classroom, yet she was still seemed fitting in that classroom. So there's definitely some nightmarish stuff going on, and they've been keeping it quite to the theme of the first game, and I like it. But in the teaser, they said, "Teacher, an educator with an unusual ability to detect troublemakers. Her class is full of well-behaved children, which explains why every little student seems the exact same. And upon us entering that classroom by accident or by intentional means, she will send her goons, students, to chase us. And those little goons with those haircuts try to take us down for good." Mid-2020, it's coming your way with Little Nightmares 2. Now, before we get to Dark Deception and the final news, I'm announcing a new segment in our videos, and that segment is called The Good Stuff of the Day. Basically, anything that I wanted to cover but couldn't make an entire video on it, I will include small seconds of news or piece of it in this video, so that way your time wouldn't be wasted and I will get what I want. Basically, we both get what we want in this segment. So each segment will have a couple of stuff, both from movie side and gaming side. You don't have to worry about it because it revolves in the same theme as Dark Deception. Anyways, the first good stuff of the day is A Quiet Place 2. This is a very popular movie from last time. I loved it. It was one of the most intriguing and fascinating movie concepts I've ever seen. Basically, it is a movie where you have to be quiet, hence the quiet place. You make a sound, the monster will chase you, and it wouldn't take a second to claw himself through you. Yes, that doesn't make any sense, but you get the point, you get the picture. But that's not what we're talking about. A Quiet Place 2, the sequel to that popular horror movie, got its final trailer a couple of days ago. And yes, this movie will drop late this month. Super excited for this one. I'll be taking day off just to watch it over and over again. Then we got one of my childhood favorite series of all time, Samurai Jack, making its first appearance in mainstream gaming industry after a very long time. They had this reveal trailer from Adult Swim where they showed the fantastic side of him that fanbase actually deserves, and rightly so. Samurai Jack Battle Through Time. The game is supposed to release mid-2020, so you can bet that we are all here for it. And finally, the good stuff of the day comes from Super Massive Game, the team behind Until Dawn and the team behind the first game of the Dark Pictures Anthology series, a horror game series, by the way. Man of Medan came with second installment of that series, Little Hope, second teaser trailer. Technically, it is a combination and compilation of people being excited for that game, but Little Hope is something that I'm looking forward to because Man of Medan, the first game in this series, and the game before that, Until Dawn, and there was another in-between game that they released. It was also fascinating. Their acting is amazing, stories, script, the choices, all of that good stuff is in this game, so you can bet that all of this I will be covering on the channel because Little Hope is something that we actually need every once in a while. So yeah, that was good stuff of the day, and if you want me to talk about all of these good stuff as separate videos, you know what to do. Let me know in those comments down below. We are into the last month of first quarter, March, and we have yet to get any announcement from Dark Deception devs regarding the release date for both Dark Deception Mobile or Dark Deception Chapter 4. They've been quite silent the entire February. Looks like they're following the Quiet Place script. I'm sorry, I'll stop with that movie now. Until last couple of days, it all started on Glowstick Entertainment's Instagram page and later here on Twitter, where they shared even more Dark Deception Mobile pictures. They said, quote, "Dark Deception Chapter 2 on the go with Manor gameplay, this time with actual Gold Watcher." And I can't really tell you how impressed I am with this port, especially Gold Watchers. We can see the speed boost as always. We can see Gold Watchers being, well, Gold Watchers doing their kind of stuff, so that's a good thing. But in the second picture, we get a really weird cropped version of Elementary Evil, and more specifically our first look at Agatha. Now here we can definitely see how much bigger of a difference it is between mobile port and PC. Shadows and Lightning, it's off. They're telling their story pretty well, but regardless, it is a mobile port. What did you expect? Did you expect 4K, 8K gaming in this? Stop it. Nonetheless, here's Agatha on phone, and let me tell you, in PC, we sometimes had an advantage because it was dark. We couldn't see her running through the hallways, but now we can definitely see her, and that's not a good thing. So good luck to us. But that's not all. You might be wondering, how are we supposed to beat these levels without teleportation powers? Well, you can, and you will. It's confirmed that we will have more powers, and more so, we now know how will it work. On Twitter, when someone asks, how will teleport work? They said, press button to activate, tap screen to complete teleport. Basically, you press teleportation on the bottom right section, and then you will use your finger to determine the distance. Either that, or there is a specific distance. Regardless, you will need to use your finger to move your camera. How are you supposed to move the teleportation? So maybe there's already a predetermined teleportation distance, and if there's a wall in front of you, you will just teleport right in front of it. I know it sounds complicated, but again, you touch that teleportation and you tap it again to teleport to that section. I think it'll be a predetermined distance, which is, well, I'm not gonna say it's unfair, but it's the best we could get on phone. Trust me, it'll work. At least we're getting teleportation power. We're not getting freaked over. And also, Vince Leaving also said, and this is really good, and this is actually really important. He said on Twitter, quote, "One new feature in DD Mobile that players will enjoy, when you use the last checkpoint to continue, you continue with the same number of remaining shards as when you died." So let's say you had one or two left and you died. Now you don't have to start the level all over the beginning. You will start with two shards left. But of course, he said, quote, "but of course you give up that S rank by doing that. It is still better than what we PC users get." And I also started a petition to get this feature for PC. But that's not all, because there's more. Vincent Livings, the executive director of Dark Deception, posted a surprise screenshot from Dark Deception Mobile. But it's not chapter 1 or 2. Yes, that is right. He said, and I quote, "even when we get the lighting wrong on mobile, it still looks kind of cool, where we can see chapter 3. Yes, chapter 3. And you can see we got duckies in here, we got map in there, we got ring altar to get out when we need it. So yeah, the lighting is not very good. It still looks alright to me. Chapter 3 will be very fun to play on phone because there are duckies and their dance. So I need that toy. Please, Dark Deception, release some sort of collector's edition." But here's more, which has me suspicious of off the release date. Now we're moving towards the release date section. When someone asks, so I guess that you've decided to release the port with three chapters. He said, yes, it will be all three chapters at the same time. So that explains the delay. If chapter 4 is getting delayed, why waste time to wait? I'm talking about the mobile team, when we can use that time to work on chapter 3 for mobile and release that as well. I think it's a smart decision by them, and now we may have all three chapters on PC and phones before chapter 4. That would be awesome. Then we can finally level up things and we can finally focus on chapter 4. No other distractions. It's not happening in this quarter. Maybe next quarter, sure, but now it seems too good to be true. Anyways, what's your take on the news? Any news, both screenshots and delays and expectations for mobile port overall? I reckon we are in for a heck of a ride. We have Little Nightmares, Resident Evil 3, Little Hope, Dark Pictures, Samurai Jack, we got A Quiet Place 2. Man, 2020 is tight for horror games, but people don't understand. I'm out here. Make sure to share your theories for any news at all in those comments and watch these videos that I made. They're a real deal. They're on your screen right now, and I will leave you here with 25k coming very soon.